bigger. I'm an unforgiving wild dog. Something wrong with her. Got a
mom
dinner. I'm a good printer. I'm a great leader. Yeah, I am what I am. I don't have no time for
that. And a little dry on the finish. No, it, I don't know. It's not really, I'm not feeling the buttery. Yesterday I did bread and butter. That one's really good. This one, it's okay. Don't get caught up on the title. It's middle of the road. I won't give it a total thumbs down. Middle of the road there. Okay, I don't like what my hair is doing with the tip there. Try to fix it a little bit. All right. Hey, Wayne. Thank you for watching. I know this is probably boring for you, so I appreciate it. I appreciate everybody that joins in to watch me. I hope it's uplifting for you for your Saturday. Is it Saturday? Yeah, Saturday. Cat dog today. So, for those of you who do not know me, my name is Angelique. I am the shoe chick. And when you paint with me, kids in Africa get shoes. I have a studio in the fabulous downtown Las Vegas where it was nice and beautiful and sunny. I think it was in the 80s today. And I have my beautiful co-host with me, Miss Liza Daniels. Woo woo woo! And Liza will be watching the screen for me, answering any questions that you might have. For those of you who have never painted with me before, this is called a virtual paint party. Most of these people painted with me today, pulled up in front of my studio, I loaded their materials in their car, and then they joined me on Facebook Live to paint. Or some people might just watch the replay. I also have a YouTube channel, Angelique Paints. So you can get a group together and have your own party. How cool would that be? Okay, let's get into it. Let's get painting. I hope you put water in your cup. And they all got a 16 by 20 free choice canvas. This is Paint Party 101. Not trying to teach you anything fancy here. The objective is to have fun. That is our objective today, okay? So, have fun. Get your wine, get your music, and enjoy the painting experience, okay? So, it was like perfect like earlier, and now it's not perfect. Oh, maybe when I switched it up, I kind of messed up. Okay, I think I'm good enough. All right, so, there are no mistakes, right? The objective is to have a good time. I love this painting. It's so simple. But I'm going to talk more as we get into it. Here's our little reference photo right here at the top. You're going to take that out. And for all you obsessive compulsive people, they're going to want to make it look just like Ron. Sorry, I was just looking at something funny. Because I need my music back. But anyway. Okay, so you're going to go into your bag of goodies here. Some of you got a little special gift from Mary Kay. One of my friends donated a lot of them to the party yesterday, and I had some left over, so I just randomly put it in the bag. There were some satin hands from Sonora, from Mary Kay. Her phone number is on the back of that gift certificate. So anyway, I wanted to make sure I get a shout out to her. I'm taking this foam brush, I'm dunking it in my water, I'm putting a light coat of water on my canvas. And for those of you who haven't painted with me before and you're wondering, why is she doing that? It's to activate the canvas so it's ready to accept paint. Don't worry about washing the trace lines away. They don't go away that easily. They're more than just pencil. But they will erase off. So I'm just activating them evenly on the sides because I'm gonna paint the sides of my paint. All right, everybody doing that? And then I want you to rest your paintbrush, your sponge paintbrush, on the tray. I never want you to rest that paintbrush in the water because it's going to soak up all the water that you have. And we're never going to need that much water in a painting. Okay? So, we're going to wait a little bit for you to do that. And then we're going to get into doing the background. So we're going to paint a lot of things blue, obviously. There's some specific points on here, like like, we got to make sure the butts of the cat and the dog are on that main branch. And we want to make sure that we have a circle. Like, I kind of debated about, like, putting a paper plate in there and having you trace it, but we can work this out. Because Liza reminded me last time that everybody can't do a circle. Okay. I think it's better when I have instrumental music, because I don't have to yell so loud. I hope my microphone is helping. Because I feel like it's not. I feel like I'm yelling still. I think it's because I just like to yell.
You need some vocal cords.
Hello? Huh?
You need some vocal cords.
Okay. So I'm going right into my blue paint. Now, if you have a lot of water on here, you want to squeeze it out. Probably not with your hand. I'm a messy painter, so I don't mind squeezing it with my hand. But you can take that blue paper towel and kind of dry it off a little bit. Now, you know what? This reference photo makes it look like the background was purple. I just noticed that today. But the background wasn't purple. The original painting, the background is blue. But if you have purple at home, you want to do purple. Tanya, I know purple is your color. You probably do a purple. But anyway, my Las Vegas time. So I'm taking the tip of my paintbrush, just the very tip. And I'm going to outline. You're the whole reason I have this thing on today. Turn the volume up on your computer, girl. I hope you guys can help me hear me okay. I'm serious. This is the whole reason I have this speaker. Okay, I bought a Bluetooth mic too, but that doesn't seem loud enough to me. Okay, now what we're going to do, we're going to paint the background blue. Very small amount on my paintbrush. Long strokes, and there is a line right there. I'm just gonna do that line. I'm painting over that line. We're gonna come back. We can come back to it later. This is just not gonna work out. Now the cool thing about painting this whole background blue in this particular painting is that it's really blue. Like the whole thing is like solid blue. So I want you to just go ahead, take your time. I'm going fast as I always do. Okay. I'm painting the sides again, of course. And if you want to put a little bit of extra paint in your paintbrush, because there's a lot of background that we have to do, I would recommend putting it on the side so you can get this broad stroke and get better coverage. Hope you guys had a good week. It's been crazy. It's crazy out there in these streets. Our mayor said some crazy stuff. Got us all in a tizzy. States are opening. Y'all be safe. And I hope this takes your mind off that stuff. I shouldn't even be talking about it. I'm not going to talk about it anymore. And look, in these brush strokes, I'm really trying to make the paint even. Because sometimes we like to leave a little white coming through. I don't want white coming through. I want it totally to be full. I'm not worried about seeing that tail. You're going to be able to see it a little bit through there. But I'm not really worried about it. You guys know I don't usually paint with sponge brushes, but they do the trick for the background and these big areas you need to cover. But if you're going to paint with me all the time, invest in some paint brushes. I would be using like a way bigger paintbrush, not a sponge brush, but this one works. Going into my paint again, doing the other side. I'm going to try to use the flat of the paintbrush, not the tip, so I can get better coverage. So, I usually take you about 90% through the painting and then leave you to do the other, 10%. And then I look forward to your post in the morning. When I get up in the morning, I look and see what your paintings look like. So thank you for all of you who tag me and post your paintings. I appreciate that. my quarantine special, the low, low price of just $15. Usually it's $25 to pay with me. Next week I'm only doing one party, because these Facebook Lives have generated a lot of business for me in other areas of my heart. So getting kind of busy. So only one next week. And it's kind of a girly one, so sorry guys. I was going to do a girl and a guy one, but I just have a lot of artwork to do. And you don't have to, I don't like to rush the artwork, you know what I mean? That's no fun when I have to rush. So I decided that I was just going to do one paint party next week. And I hope that's okay with you guys. And it's going to be on Saturday. So I am finished with my background. You're probably not, because I'm going fast. I'm okay with it. I might go around and put another coat on it. And I can still see those lines, those pencil lines. I hope you can too. Now you know, I always say there are no mistakes, right? There really are no mistakes. But there are some key points that you want to make sure that you kind of get in painting. Now the major key point, I think, to this painting is that it is a circle, okay? It's like try to make it as close to a circle as you can. Like, try to make sure it's even. Most of you got a piece of chalk in there, because after I started getting out kits, I was like, you know, I should put some chalk in there to kind of help them out with the circle. If you did not get a piece of chalk, you might want to grab a pencil, okay? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a line straight down the middle of, you're not going to be able to see it, but you know what I'm doing. I guess you could grab a pencil. If I grab a pencil, you can probably see it a little better. I'm going to draw a line right in the middle. Oh, you can't, because I use my pencils for everything. Anyway, the line of symmetry. I want to make it as much as even on this side as that side. So it's better, easier, I think, to look at it as two halves than a whole. Less intimidating. With me? Say yes. Somebody say yes.
Lazy?
You're lazy today? It's okay. Hi, Michelle. Michelle from New York is watching. Let me do some shout-outs for the paid fans in here. Man, I got people that picked up like 5 kits at a time, 7 kits at a time. Y'all must be having a party. If it's somebody's birthday, shout it out for me so I can shout it out. So I just want to say thank you to Lisa and Ethan. I hope you're painting with me today. To Holly and her 3 friends. Maritza, Nancy, Kayla, Kenyatta, Janice, Naisha, and Leandra. I mean, I have some really loyal painters out there. I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. And if I miss your name, I am so sorry. I want to say charge it to my, what is it? Charge it to my head and not to my heart, because I appreciate you all. Hey, that's the thing. She just like laughed at me on that. Okay. So I'm waiting for you guys to finish your backgrounds, because I know you're not finished. I'm going to wait a little. Leslie, do you have any questions for me?
Or does anybody have any questions for me?
So, which one do you prefer more?
I can't hear you.
What do you prefer more, cats or dogs?
Cats and dogs. I am a dog person, not really a fan of cats. Yeah. I've actually never owned a cat, so that's not fair to the cat community. I wouldn't even know what to do with it. Anything else? You got a follow-up to that?
Yeah, what's your favorite dog breed?
Oh, I think anybody that knows me knows my favorite dog breed is Beagle. I've had 3 Beagles. And I currently have one at the house right now that's about 14. And he's having a hard time right now. A really hard time. He like walks sideways. But he still eats and drinks and goes up and down the stairs and his tail wags. So they tell me you will know when it's time. So anyway, yeah. And then I have a little mutt at home, which I got him as a therapy dog when we were going through some things, and he's been wonderful. We rescued him from the shelter. Her face while you guys are working on your background. Because I thought it was funny. I thought the whole thing, like the cat and dog, actually there were two separate paintings and I put them together because I just thought it would be funny. Just when I look at it, it's just funny to me. When I posted today, and I was like, oh, nobody's like buying the cat dog. I was like, maybe my sense of humor is off. But I just thought it was funny because it's so, like, you know, cats and dogs aren't usually big friends and they're like chilling right there. So that's why I like it. Okay, so, ooh, crap. Okay, so now I'm taking my blue yellow paintbrush. Hi, Susan. And I am taking that blue yellow paintbrush. I'm putting a little bit of water on it. I'm going right into my white paint. Now, this is what I'm going to do. I am softening up this line right here between the blue and the white. Softening the line. If you look at a reference photo, it's kind of a soft line. It's not like hard and sloppy. So I'm softening the line. And I'm trying to get some uniformity in the line. I want it to be nice and smooth. I don't want it to be lumpy. So I'm working my way around. I might even drag a little bit of blue into the circle. That's okay. So I'm taking another little bit of white paint, dragging it along, smoothing out my edges, paying attention to that line of symmetry that I drew with my chalk because I want it to be even on both sides, as even as I can get it. You might be extending the circle out a little bit because it doesn't look round to you.
Vanessa says I should have gotten my kit yesterday. Nancy says, thank you for doing the virtual paint parties for us.
You're welcome.
And Michelle said, how far in advance do you choose what canvases you'll be using?
What canvases or what image?
It says what canvases.
We always paint on 16 by 20 canvases. When I mail kits out, it's on an 11 by 14 canvas because it's less expensive. You know, this would be kind of expensive to nail. So, I'm going to have an interesting post later in the week. Like, if you want a pink cat dog, like, any day of the week, you can come down and pick up a kit for me. And you can go to my YouTube channel. This will be up on Tuesday on YouTube. So, you can pick up a kit of anything, even as far back as number one. What do we do, number one? Fierce Fairy. You can pick up a Fierce Fairy kit. Say that 10 times after this buttery bombshell Chardonnay.
Oh, she said I meant what picture was.
Yeah, you know what? It's been challenging because I've never painted this much before. So I kind of think of a painting like for the ladies. Friday is usually something I want to paint. Something fun that's come from, like from my heart. Like something silly. Usually it's something Afrocentric a lot of the times that I do on Fridays. And then on Saturdays, I try to do something more family. What I'm working on next week is it's really something different. So it doesn't even look like something I would paint. I think it's fun. I'm interested to see the reaction that I get when I put it out. But I'm gonna put that painting out on Tuesday. So I'm softening up the edges. Y'all see that? Now, we can let the white serve in the background as part of the moon, or you can paint it in. It's totally up to you. I'm kind of looking at the reference photo a little bit to see if I dragged any blue in the middle, and I don't really think I did, but you can. If you drew a chalk line in there, you want to cover that up a little bit with the white paint, and if you can't get it with the white paint, you might want to put a little tiny bit of blue on your paintbrush. So that you can cover it up. And now I got a little bit of blue in my moon. And I'm okay with that. Because I'm going to use, we got lots of white paint. So I'm going to use the white paint and kind of blend it in a little bit. So I want my moon to mostly be white. Now if your paint's a little sticky, you're going to add a little bit of water to your paintbrush. Little bit of blue in there, and I'm okay. Remember, I think it's kind of important that it's round. Now what I'm going to do, I'm squishing my paintbrush around in the water. Then I'm going to dry it off really good on my paper towel. And I'm sorry, I forgot to tell you, there's an apron in there, but you probably figured that out already. You're a little bad. We're painting with acrylic paints and water-based. They wash off your hands and stuff very easily. Not so much out of your clothes. So if you get it on your clothes, it's probably, if you get it right away, it'll come out. But if you let it sit there, it'll pretty much set, okay? So, where are we at here? I'm gonna give you a few minutes. Leslie, you have any questions? Okay, you know.
What's been your favorite virtual paint writing picture you've done so far?
My favorite one? I don't think I was ready for that question. I don't know. I kind of like them all. I really like the Flower Girl one. That was an Angelique original. The Lollipop Girl was an Angelique original. The Balloon Girl yesterday was the Balloon Girl. I like the Balloon Girl yesterday. I thought that that was a really unique one. And that was an Angelique. Thank you for asking. I can tell you my least. You want to know my least favorite?
Sure.
Probably the fairy.
What?
The fair fairy. I don't know. I should like it because it was the first one. But I don't know. I look at it and I go, what was I thinking? A butterfly would have been fun. All right. Wiped out my paintbrush. It is very, very dry. I'm going into my black paint. Just the tip, very, very tip of it. And I'm outlining.
That's why it's only $15.
getting better and better every time. Okay. I just went all over those trace ones that I have. So my dog was, it looks kind of funny on the screen. I don't know how it looks for you out there, but I'm going to put another coat on and finish up the lines and make it all nice and neat and pretty. And so are you. So right now, if you notice, there's like a little gap right here. And the reason for that gap is like the trunk of the tree. So what we're going to do now is fill in that portion. We're going to paint it in. And this is where it gets fun. This is where you take your chalk and you get to get all willy-nilly with your, you get to get crazy with your tree branches. Now you can be totally obsessed. I'm putting a little black on the side because I like to wrap my paintings like really cool, but if you look on the side of it, I might even extend a branch like on this side. So if you look on the side of it, it has another effect. Okay, so. Y'all with me? I hope y'all with me. This is such an easy painting. It's so fun. I love it. I love the silhouettes. I was going to do a horse. What other animals should I do? I was going to do a giraffe too. That's kind of funny. Like a big facing giraffe. Okay. It's gonna be rough when it's 120 outside and we have to turn off the air. It's not like this thing out. Okay, so what am I doing next? I'm gonna take my chalk. I'm only taking 90% of this painting, so what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna show you how to do branches and leaves. Then I'm bouncing. So, if you're OCD, or if you really want to look like my painting, you're going to follow the lines in the painting. So, make sure you paint the tree trunk all the way down. These are silhouettes, so they should be opaque. You shouldn't see any blue in there. Should be dark, dark, dark. No water on the paintbrush unless your paint is sticky. Some of you guys have medium-bodied black paint that I use. And you might have to add a little bit of water because I'm experimenting with different like mediums. Usually we paint with a very thin acrylic paint. That's why we have to put like two coats on when we paint. But if you're really going to get into painting, I want to encourage you to buy like Golden Brand. If you're going to Michael's, look at the advanced, the medium-bodied ones. I never really use the heavy ones. I tried to, and I didn't like paint with them. You have to sometimes add different additives to them to make them smooth like you want. But, you know, it's always good to experiment, right? So I'm going to take the chalk, and I'm going to chalk out some tree branches. I got one coming on the bottom. I got one coming down here. That's an important one. You know what the important tree branches are? That one that's coming right in the moon. Because you want to show that that's a way. That's pretty cool. When I was painting this picture, I just kind of just all did it all freehand. And then as I went along, I just added different branches. All those in because it's going to take too much time. I'm just going to show you how to do some of the tree branches. A little bit of black paint. Following on my chalk lines. If you want to get like a thinner line at the beginning, it's a lot of pressure in the beginning and then you kind of lighten up as you get to the end. So if you want to have that wispy look, a lot of pressure in the beginning and then you lighten up towards the end. A lot of pressure in the beginning and lighten up at the end. And you might want to have, you know, short ones, long ones. Totally up to you. But I think that one of the most important branches are the ones that are going through the moon, because those look cool. Don't be scared, just do it. you don't like the way it looks, you can just put a little white lint behind it and make them thinner. So I said I wasn't going to do a bunch of branches, but it kind of gets fun after a while. You know? Just have fun with it. But make sure you get that one or two or however you want into the mood. Let's say you put one in and you don't like it. Too bad. No, kidding. Just take black paint and cover it up a little bit. Okay, so how do you make those leaves? If you look at the leaves, they're light blue and dark blue. That's it. Light blue and dark blue. But there is a little something else that's added to the paint. In the background, there is a hint of black. And I really hesitate to have you guys use the black because sometimes it just messes people up, to be honest with you. I'm going to show you a different way to use it to add the black in than we've done in the past. I'm going to put a little bit of the blue paint in my mixing tray. I'm going to take a little bit of black paint with my sponge brush, and I'm going to mix it in my tray. And it gives me kind of like a funky color of blue with black, blue black. Then I'm going to take my sponge brush, and I'm going to add a little bit on the edges to kind of imply that it's dark outside. Now, in the past, what we were doing is I had you dip into the black and then add streaks and blend it in. And yeah, that didn't seem to work too well. People were having a hard time with that. So let's mix it in our tray first, and then let's add the nightfall. With our sponge brush. I think that works a little bit better. Watch me first and then they paint. They don't necessarily paint while I'm painting. Just watch how to do it and you watch the replay. Alright, so I need to show you leaves. There's little sparkles in the background too, and you guys know how to do that. They're just little dots with the back of your paintbrush basically. See, I've altered my circle a little bit, so I'm going to go back, and I'm going to put some white and smooth out the edge of my moon, because it's really important that that line is smooth for me. I don't mind the blue getting in there, but it's important to me that it's smooth. Did y'all notice I forgot the tail? Can we just talk? Can we just talk? Talk about me. I have to breathe on my ear, my tail, so I don't see it anymore. Don't forget the tail. Work with one color at a time. So you're gonna work with some dark blue, and you're gonna go around and you're gonna just do a whole bunch of little brush strokes, upward brush strokes. I almost did some right there, but that's not the end of the branch. That's the end of the branch. Now, if you notice, you can't really see them on the dark ones, right? So on the dark background, you want to make sure on the dark blue that you put light colored leaves. We're going to add more and more white. Because I want it to be really light. If you can see that. My mixing tray is always a mess. And the reason why I added more white is because it wasn't standing out enough for me. Isn't that fun? The more leaves you put on it, probably the better that it looks. I just kind of stopped. And I just did like small ones. I thought that was a tail at first, but that's a branch. Alright? That's cool. There's a few things that, like what I would recommend is that you take your time, work around the painting, smooth things out a little, like this black on the top. I'm not feeling that too much. I want to smooth it out a little bit. Those starlights in the background, those twinkles in the background. You can just take the back of your paintbrush, dip it in the white paint. Be careful, you don't want to drill. Get a light on it. And if you don't want to do it like that, that's my favorite way to do it. You can use the corner of your flat paintbrush, and you can do it like that. That's how the twinkles are done. I think I've given you every component to the painting. What I would do is work your way carefully around the painting. Enjoy the experience. Turn your music up. Put another coat on the dog and the cat to make it really opaque. Make sure you have a clean line around your moon. Not an oval, not a triangle, not a heart. I mean, you can do a heart if you want. You can do anything you want. It's your painting. I always tell everybody this is Paint Party 101. The objective is to have fun, right? So I really hope we had fun today. It's rough, right? It's hard to keep your spirits up these days, and I'm happy that I can be a very small part of it to help uplift your spirits, really, because it's tough. It's getting tough. Make sure you post your pictures. You know how much I enjoy that. I really, really do. And I appreciate your support. And I'll be posting the new picture on Tuesday. And I'm trying to think of if there's anything else. Oh, my YouTube channel, Angelique Paints. I'll put a link down there. I'll probably be posting more about it. Eventually, these are going to be private groups. So I created a private group on Facebook. Some of you might have got alerted to it. And it's called Angelique Paints. Because eventually, everybody won't be able to see these paintings, see me do it. Because you could actually just get a canvas on your own and just follow along, right? And that's not fair to the people that paid. I mean, I don't care right now because it's quarantine time and I want you to have your time, but I'm just saying. In the future, you'll pay, then you'll get access to a page, and then we'll paint together. So, anyway, I just wanted to share that information with you. Liza's laughing at me, not quite sure why, but it's okay. So I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. Liza, you're going to come over here and show your cute little face because Granny loves to see your face. Hi, Mom. I should do that. Hi, Mom. You want to say hi, Granny?
Hi, Granny.
My mom's in Michigan. I don't know when I'll ever see her again because of what's going on, but she watches us from time to time. I do have to go, kids, if you're interested. Not all the images are available to go, but I can mail one to your loved ones. It's kind of a cool, fun thing to do, so. Once again, thank you so much. Have a great week. Be safe. Angelique out. Thank you.